Every now and then, somebody asks me what I do for work, and I always struggle to explain what Raycast is. I try to stay away from the term launcher, because I wonder if they're gonna understand what it means. So today I wanna focus on this term and dive deeper into one of the main reasons that you'd use Raycast for, opening up applications. If you're not familiar with the concept of a launcher, that's absolutely fine. Let's start with a little walkthrough. Imagine you wanna open up a browser. Most people will do this. They use their mouse, go to the dock, look for Safari and click on it. There, I've just launched my browser. But what happens when the app that you're looking for doesn't exist in your dock? Another option that's a little less common is using the macOS Launchpad. It puts all of your apps into a visual grid that you can pick from and choose which one to open. A lot of people don't know about this, but honestly, it's kind of clunky and hard to organize and find stuff. A while ago, Apple came up with a feature called Spotlight.
And the technology we've developed to do that is called Spotlight.
It's like a text box that you can open up by pressing a specific combination of keys on your keyboard. And from there, you can search for files, open up applications, and even search the web. It's a much more efficient way to look for the next thing you want to do on your computer, and getting used to working like this can really improve your productivity. But here's the thing. Here at Raycast, we thought we could make it even better. So let's explore launching applications the Raycast way. Just like we saw before in Spotlight, you can open up Raycast by pressing a hotkey. Mine is Command Space. Then if you want to open an app, say your calendar, you can just search for it and press Enter. It doesn't matter if the app is open or closed. If I open up Raycast, type in Safari and press Enter, it will take me right back to where I was before in my browser. Now, you know how in your dock, you can keep the apps that you use the most often? Well, in Raycast, you can do that by searching for it, opening up the action panel and selecting Add to Favorites. The action panel is something that you're gonna use a lot when using Raycast, and you can always get to it by pressing Command K. Here's how I can add another app to my favorites by only using the keyboard. Let's search for favorite, and here it is. I can just press Enter and add the calendar app to my favorites. If you look closely, you'll notice that you can do this directly by using the Add to Favorites hotkey without having to open the action panel altogether. Every time you encounter an action you're going to use a lot, it's good practice to memorize its shortcut. All right, now I want to show you two more ways that you can open applications even faster, by creating aliases and hotkeys. In Raycast terms, opening an application is known as a command. And with any command, you can set hotkeys and aliases. Now, I use Spotify for all my music, so I'm going to add an alias to it. It's like a nickname for all your favorite apps and commands. All I have to do is open the action panel, search for configure, and press enter. This way, every time I want to listen to something, I can open up Raycast, search for music, and Spotify will show up. While we're at it, let's configure a hotkey for the Photos app. And this time, I'm using the keyboard shortcut for that, which is Command Shift Comma. Let's do Control P for Photos. And there you go. From anywhere I am on my Mac, I can now just press Control P to launch my Photos app. Okay, that's all for today. I know we've gone over a lot of new concepts, especially if you've been opening up apps with your mouse through the dock. It's perfectly normal to feel a little bit overwhelmed at first, and to even forget that you installed Raycast and go back to using your mouse. I promise you though, if you make an effort to practice the shortcuts and techniques until they become muscle memory, you're going to be opening apps here and there even quicker than your computer can. And you're going to start using some Raycast commands that even I don't know about. If you want to learn more about the power of Raycast, make sure to subscribe for more tips like this. And check out this playlist with a bunch of tutorials we've recently published.